a good man, Charlie Mr. Brown. That is not the same thing that you meant to say.
The Grinch, dude.
The Grinch.
How the Grinch stole Christmas.
Merry Xmas, Charlie Brown from Parmesan? Parmesan or yeah, it's got to be Parmesan.
Parmesan. Parmesan.
Like Parmesan, but Sean.
Parmesan.
Parmesan.
Dude, if I had a name that was similar to the end of a cheese, I would
embrace it.
I would make that pun.
Embrace your dreams.
Encouraging Emperor Palpatine.
You know it.
Never give up on your dreams. If you need to take on a second job to go to college, so be it.
Ask her out on a date. Do it.
Do it.
Court her well.
Oh, I do believe. You will be quite operational. Oh my god. All right. Charlie Brown Christmas. What are we looking at here? Is that the piano?
Oh yeah. Dude, these dudes just
is this the pageant?
Oh, maybe.
Or is this the Christmas tree lot? This
I'm being laughed at.
Oh yeah, this is the tree. Christmas tree lot. I get it. And it's snowing outside. Snowing. Snow is very dangerous.
Yo, we should go see the Charlie Brown movie.
Peanuts?
Yeah.
Dude.
I heard it's weird, but we should see it.
Dude, I'm all about that, dude.
Oh, no.
Like a year or two ago, Inglourious Bath, was it? No, it was Django Unchained.
Django.
Django Unchained and Wreck-It Ralph. Like yeah. Christmas time double feature. That was great.
Yeah, Alex and I.
That was long ago. That
yeah,
was like 2 years ago.
That was when we first started Beard Bros, yeah. I think. Yeah.
Like
we were
like,
still.
It was like the
we were
day
still
after
doing
Christmas.
Wild Arms. Yeah. Yeah.
It's like the day after Christmas or so. We like did some Beard Bros and then we were just like, let's just like go do stuff. And we like went to one movie theater and then we like went somewhere else and ate and went to another movie theater and saw both of those movies.
We almost did three. Yeah. We wanted to see Lord of the Rings as well.
Yeah,
Hobbit.
Yeah. Dude, what's the deal with that Yoshi?
I think I was going to try and get him, but... Oh, it's the Christmas tree.
Woo! Oh! Was that the snow? That shattering glass? That's great. Hey, Merry Christmas, everybody, right?
Merry Christmas.
Hashtag, what did you get? I know it kind of goes against the true meaning of Christmas, but...
What did you get, Alex?
What did I get?
What do you? Let's make predictions.
I actually know what I got.
What do you think you were gonna get from your family?
I actually already know what I got. Remember? Because didn't I say that on here or was it on the Dex podcast?
I don't know.
I can't remember. My mom like insists on buying me things for Christmas, right? Even though I'm like almost 30 years old, and I'm always just like, no. You like always tell me about your money problems. Like you shouldn't buy me gifts. But she's like, just give me a list of like a few like. Movie price things and a few game price things and I'll be the judge. And I was like, all right. And I gave her a list, but I mean, I don't know if she realizes it or what, but like we share the same Amazon Prime account.
So you can see what she's getting you.
And like, I use it so much more than her that I actually get notifications to my phone. Like when things ship.
Sure.
And so I know everything that I'm getting for Christmas from my mom. So, like, I could predict with 100% accuracy. I mean, maybe she got some extra stuff in real life. Or maybe she got gifts for someone else that are exactly what I asked for, but I just feel so bad about it. I don't know what to do. I'll tell you, me and Kelly, we decided instead of getting each other, like, gifts, we're going to buy a bed. Because our bed is, like, too small and old and crappy. Think about buying a, oh my god. All right. Like, I mean, that's not normally, like, how I write Xmas, because it makes it look, like, severe. I don't even know. Xmas.
I'm not going to lie. I don't know what happened here.
Okay, so...
I was a fan. I thought it was funny to put the face on the popper.
The party popper.
And then I kind of stopped and said, why did I do that?
It's kind of like a face coming out of a popper. Like,
yeah.
Or it's, like, a
spaceship. It's a flower. It's a Christmas flower. That's what I'm calling it.
Yeah, like that tradition where you put, you draw a face on the center of a flower.
Patrick, call this episode Christmas Flower.
It's a classic holiday tradition. Not sure what.
Christmas time flower form.
Beard Bros homework, everybody send Jirard, because this is his old Khalil family Christmas tradition, send him, Photoshop your face onto a flower and send it to Jirard.
That's not true.
Yeah, this is, that's a Christmas flower. Beard Bros homework. Photoshop your own face or Jirard's face into the center of a flower and send it to us.
No, don't do
that.
That's
so funny. That'll be your...
Don't.
That's all you got to do to give us presents today.
Look, I am the worst at Christmas. I am much better when someone tells me what they want. Amanda was like, I want this art set. And I was like, great, Amazon Primed. It's at your door tomorrow. Merry Christmas. I'm so sorry.
What? What did she get you?
I got her... She wanted a art set. So I bought her an art set.
Did you just tell her you got it for her?
She told me to get it for her, so I did.
She was like, buy this for me for Christmas.
Yeah.
I see.
And I was like, okay, and so I did. Things are much easier for me that way.
That's so much better. Like, how much time do you spend stressing about it? You know what I
way
mean?
Way too much. Yeah. I premeditate for weeks.
That's why I like the bed so much. Like, I'm sure that I'm...
I got my dad a ball launcher for the dogs.
A ball launcher?
Yeah.
Like one of those arms?
Yeah. Like... Oh my god, this level.
Like the handheld ones or like a machine?
It's like a machine. It's like a machine gun kind of. It's like a super scoper. You pump it once. Yeah,
because he's getting a little older.
Yeah, he always throws the balls for the dogs, right? Yeah. So he just gets a tennis ball, puts it in there, and shoots it. The dog run gets it, brings it back. Tyson's going to love it. My dad's going to love it. It's going to be great. What do you get a man who has everything in the world?
A robot ball launcher.
Exactly. That costs $25 from Bed Bath & Beyond. I love you, Dad. You don't listen to this.
Maybe he'll start now. He was so proud of us.
For the album?
Yeah. I've never seen him like that before. It was like off-putting.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. Oh my god. This is so complex.
Woodstock.
Oh my god, dude. Pick a tree. Right? Yeah, pick a tree.
Oh. Nope. Oh, no. Oh, I see.
This is what I'm talking about with these metal trees. Blockhead.
Blockhead!
You're a blockhead. Emily, this is great. Holy shit. Oh my god. Are you hearing this?
Yes.
How long did that take you? Oh my god. Jesus. There it is.
Emily, you win Beard Bros.
Yeah, you win Beard Bros.
You win.
That was tight.
That was so good.
That was tight.
That was incredible.
That was sick.
Did anyone see that?
That was amazing. Yeah, how come nobody say anything? That was awesome.
Emily. Emily.
Emily.
Emily.
Emily. Emily. Two syllables?
Emily.
Emily. Emily. You can't say it without saying three syllables.
I can't anymore.
Emily. Like a ghost third syllable in there. Damn. I'm always so impressed when people do stuff like that. That's why, you know, that's why those autoplay levels are so popular, is because it's just like the craftsmanship. Is that you're just like, damn, how did somebody do this? It's not like, at that point, it's not about Mario. It's just about like a neat creative tool. Like, did you ever play The Incredible Machine?
Yes.
A game is so fun just because it's fun to be creative, right? Like, it has the tasks and stuff that you can do, but especially as a younger kid, I just loved, like, fucking around with it and, like, doing all kinds of silly stuff. What do you think your family's going to get you for Christmas, Jirard? I'm pretty sure my family is getting me Xenoblade Chronicles X and Assassin's Creed Syndicate.
Emily, that was great. Thank you.
In fact, I'd say I'm 100% sure.
You know, I don't really know. I'm going to say, if I had to guess, probably clothes.
Clothes?
Clothes.
What do you think? Like,
I'm going to get a flannel.
Like a pajama?
I'm going to get a flannel. No, like an actual flannel. I'll get some flannels.
I feel like that's
some,
like, I feel
some
like
jeans.
I feel like that's like the pimp adult gift to give. It's just like a comfortable ass pair of pajamas.
Yeah.
But if you're getting a gift from work, it's going to be like probably like some kind of alcohol with like some cups in there that you stole from somebody in a White Elephant.
Dude, I looked out at the Grumps White Elephant party.
Or like a drone.
Got that StarCraft marquee. It's in the hallway.
Oh, yeah. That thing looks sweet. I didn't know that that's where that came from.
Yeah.
I thought that was just like something that we got.
Nah, man.
What did you bring?
Amiibo. I brought, I forgot that the White Elephant was $20. At the time, last year, I brought Amiibo, and the Amiibo were worth, like, $30 or $40, so everyone was freaking out. This time, because Amiibo were available everywhere, my Amiibo, like, were just $12, so I was short an Amiibo, and Aaron gave me an extra Amiibo. So great. I gave away a Ganondorf and a, Inkling Girl.
Tight. Charlie O'Brown Christmas.
This is by Sir Burger.
Sir Burger.
Sir Burger.
Charlie O'Brown.
Burger Berg. Sir oh. Burger.
Dude, shout outs to this background. Looking real cool. Dude, these guys are ready to go.
Dun 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 dun.
Da-dum. Wow.
Da-dun. Boom, boom.
What are we looking at here?
I don't know. I'm digging it, though.
Yeah, it's like a cool level.
Oh, I gotta take it back with me.
You gotta get...
I gotta
you
go
can't
back
go down?
In time. No, I tried.
Oh, you gotta take it back through to that door.
Which door? Yeah.
There was like a gold block covering the door?
Yes, this door.
So is this supposed to be the auditorium? Where they're doing the pageant.
Oh, yeah. I didn't think about that. Oof. Come join me.
Nice. Nice. Got it.
Dinner to dun dun.
There it is. Okay. There's the house. And here's the
Trek
tree.
Point.
The tree lot with like the metal trees and the wooden trees. That's what I'm talking about. These fake Christmas trees. They're so weird. I know my grandparents used to have a aluminum tree back in the day. That's game, baby.
Uh-oh.
That's got to be the end of the... I killed it. Oh. Everything.
Oh, everything is...
Oh, everything I touch,
touch is ruined.
Oh, my God. It's the part from the movie.
Yeah.
Dude, other Beard Bros homework, I don't know how old you are or if you've ever seen this before, but, like, you should definitely watch this special. It's, like, 20 minutes long, for real.
Oh, that's the end.
Yeah. It's one of the best, like, Christmas things that's, like, not super, like, a big investment. Like, you can watch it and it warms your heart and you're not, like, 2 hours down. If you do want to watch a movie, though, that's a great question of the day. Question of the day, what's your favorite Christmas movie?
Die Hard.
Die Hard? That's a pretty good one. It's like... It's like the one that's like the clear winner because it's like... Somebody had the like great idea to like make it during Christmas. Same thing with Iron Man 3. It's like during Christmas, so it's like kind of like you could watch it for Christmas. I was going to say also I love The Santa Claus with Tim Allen. And I love, what is it called? Jingle All the Way. That might be my favorite one. I don't go 1 year without watching Jingle All the Way with Sinbad and Arnold Schwarzenegger and Phil Hartman and Jake Lloyd. I love that movie, man. Ta-ta, Turtle Man.
Ta-ta, Turtle Man.
Ned, put the cookie down. Now. Rita Wilson is like kind of in the movie too. She's just like, Howard.
Uh-huh.
It's turbo time. How you doing over there? Charlie O'Brown Christmas.
Feeling good.
I want to see your visual response to your experience playing that level. Gets me hyphy.
I tried.
You tried?
This one's called I Tried.
What do we got? Oh my god. What? Is that the Red Baron?
Yeah.
Oh my god. That is hilarious. The plane has legs?
Yeah, I couldn't draw the...
I feel like landing gear?
Yeah.
Dude, let's talk about how Snoopy is like the chillest character in any...
Cartoon,
period.
Yeah. His laugh's like...
Yeah, he has a similar voice to Birdo.
Bow.
Bow. Great. One more?
Thank you for your level.
One more? How many do we do? Three?
Yeah, we've got a couple more here. If we're going to do one more, we're going to do this one.
Oh my god. Could it be? Could it truly be?
Ladies and gentlemen, making his return.
Has the prodigal son finally returned?
The prodigal son has returned.
Which is ironic because his name is...
Dad.
Dad.
It's the return of Dad, you guys.
Dad's back, baby.
Dad is back. He got away from his kids for a few minutes.
Some people think it's Christmas.
Snoopy's Xmas light contest.
Some people think it's Christmas. Guess what? It's Father's Day.
It's Father's Day.
It's Father's Day.
Oh my god, Dad.
Okay.
Dad.
Christmas lights on the house. Very clever. Now we're Snoopy. Great. Great. We climbing.
I gotta go see what's over here now. Oh, this is just houses.
Yeah. Dude, secret exit. You went out
secrets?
The chimney. Did we just, like, bypass the whole level?
I always do this with Dad's levels. I always ruin the experience somehow.
Maybe it's just because you and Dad are, like, on the same wavelength. You know, like, maybe you are... Are you Dad?
Look how big this level is.
Are you?
Aw, Dad trolled me, you guys.
Dad got you this time. You can't fool around with Dad or he's gonna spank you.
It's true. Yeah, I'll probably get some jeans or some flannels for Christmas. I'll wear them once and they'll go in the... What? Oh, yes, yeah, so I'll probably get some shoes from my dad.
Dude, Gerard's shoe stories are the best. Whoa! Christmas, it said.
Xmas! Yeah, when I was on Game Grumps, I told the story about my shoes. Or no, I didn't tell the story about my shoes. I told Dan the story, and Dan was like, "You have to tell that story in some form." So, did I tell the story on Beard Bros?
I know. I feel like I've heard it before, like not just in private, but I don't know. It's a great story.
I can tell it if you want.
You can tell. Just tell like the quick version.
Okay, so, I was 16. The Xbox 360 was just announced, I think. I really wanted a 360. My brother knew someone out there who could get one. It would cost a lot of money. So I went to my dad and I said, and my dad asked me what I want for Christmas. He goes, "What do you want for Christmas?" I go, "You know, I don't really want anything. Christmas is not really my thing." And he goes, "No, I get you for Christmas. What do you want?" I go, "Okay. I want the new Xbox 360. And he goes, "You want Xbox? I get you Xbox."
Dad, this level.
For Christmas, I got two pairs of white Kirkland Costco branded shoes. My birthday, a few weeks later, my dad asked me again what I wanted for my
birthday. Yeah,
Gerard's
birthday's on January 3rd.
Yeah, and he asked me, you know, what you want for your birthday, and I said, "Oh, I'm still holding out for that Xbox." You know, that'd be great. And he goes, "Hey, you want Xbox? I'll get you Xbox." So for my 17th birthday, I got two pair of white Kirkland Costco brand pair of shoes.
We're up to four now.
Yeah, four pair. So when I was next year, following year, it's Christmas, my dad goes, "What do you want for Christmas?" I go, "You know, I don't want anything." And he goes, No, what do you really want for Christmas?" And I go, "Well, you know, the Xbox is like about to come out. And so like, I'm really, really, really want to get one." And
right.
He goes, "You know what? You're right. I'll get you the Xbox. Like, I'll get it for you. So for Christmas, I got two pair of white Kirkland Costco brand pair of shoes. So at this point, I have six pair. And my dad goes, what do you want for your birthday? Like, oh my God, I feel bad. I'm like skipping this level.
We're like not even skipping it. It's like fucking amazing.
2016 question mark. I had to play this level in private because I was just was so absolved with the atmosphere. It was so much.
Dad strikes again.
Dad, you got me good. So for my 18th birthday, my dad goes, what do you want for your birthday? And I go, Dad, you know what? I really don't think I want anything. I think that if I ask for something, I'm going to get disappointment. He goes, no, what do you want? And I go, Dad, I'm not going to say it again. I want that Xbox. And he goes, you really want the Xbox? And I go, of course I do. And he goes, I'll get you an Xbox. So for my 18th birthday, it was me and my dad at a restaurant. And it was me, Zan, Michael Barity, I think they were all there.
Right.
He didn't do this in front of them, but we were at dinner, we came home, and everyone went home, and he's like, here's your gift. And it was an Xbox 360, and I started to freak out, but he had the biggest smirk on his face. I was like, this isn't right. Something's not right. And so I opened the box, and inside was two pair of Kirkland Costco brand pair of shoes inside of an Xbox 360 box. My dad had gotten an empty box for work because he was doing a promotion with the 360. And he got an actual 360 and just gave me an empty box.
Roasted you, trolled you.
Yeah. What's worse is that I never got that 360. My brother and I had to go buy our 360s eventually, like 2 or 3 years later.
That's amazing.
Even though he had a whole surplus of them.
That is an incredible troll.
Yeah. So that's the Xbox story. Immortalized for the internet.
There it is. You did it.
I don't know what this level's about or what I'm feeling right now.
What?
So I'm just going to draw something weird.
All right. You just feeling it? Just feeling the vibe?
I'm on it.
Yeah. You're being so meticulous. What did you make? What? You're being suspiciously quiet.
I don't know.
Did you etch a smiley face into that frog's mouth?
He already had a smiley face, but I wanted to make sure you really saw it.
Is he now that meme frog?
Yes.
The sad meme frog?
Yes.
This is a real helpful PSA warning. Like, like on this Christmas day, like, don't let it be ruined by a bad meme. Beware, you guys.
Hey, guys, don't let your dreams become memes, okay?
Thank you for joining us on Christmas, but, like...
Merry Christmas. Go do me a favor.
Yeah.
Your bro's homework. Go hug your parents.
Go hug your parents?
If you don't have parents, hug your sisters, your brothers, your uncles, your grandparents, whoever's around in your life.
Hug your buds.
Hashtag buddy... buddy bread.
Hashtag buddy bread.
Later, man.